Hi there. Today, we'll explain the next 12 essential IT terms from the Chapter 2.1 Programming Basics in our book. You can find the book linked in the description below. Let's dive in. Programming Environment: Programs in which developers write code. A robust programming environment enhances productivity and facilitates development. Data types: a particular kind of data item as defined by the values it can take, the programming language used, or the operations that can be performed on it. Understanding data types is crucial for efficient data management and manipulation in programming. Variable: a variable is a storage location in a computer's memory, identified by a name that holds a value or data which can change during program execution. Variables are fundamental in programming as they allow data to be stored and manipulated dynamically. Bug: a mistake or problem in a computer program. Identifying and fixing bugs is a critical part of software development. Logical operators: symbols used to compare logical expressions that return a result of true or false. Logical operators are essential for decision-making processes in programming. Arithmetical operators: a mathematical function that takes two values and performs a calculation on them. Arithmetical operators are used for performing basic mathematical operations in code. Loops: a set of algorithms for repeating a certain action to a specified result. Loops are crucial in programming for automating repetitive tasks. Syntax: the structure of statements in a computer language. Correct syntax is essential for ensuring that code is properly understood and executed by a computer. Arrays: a data structure consisting of a collection of elements, values, or variables. Arrays are fundamental for organizing and storing data in programming. Functions: a set of statements that performs a task or calculates a value. Functions allow for modular and reusable code in programming. Input: put data into a computer. Input is essential for interacting with and feeding data into programs. Output: out of a computer or other device. Produce, deliver, or supply data. Output is how programs communicate results back to the user or other systems. All right, team, let's plan our next software module. Sarah, since you'll be coding most of it, let's start by setting up your programming environment. Do you have everything you need?
Yes, John. I've configured the IDE, but I'll need clarity on the data types we'll be using for user input. Are we handling text, numbers, or something else?
Good point, Sarah. We'll be working with multiple data types: strings for names, integers for ages, and floats for transaction amounts. We'll also use arrays to store data sets.
Got it. I'll set up variables for these data types. By the way, will there be complex conditions? I'll need to use logical operators for decision-making in the code.
Yes, there will be scenarios requiring logical operators, especially for user authentication. Make sure the calculations for payment systems are accurate too. Use arithmetical operators where needed.
Noted. I'll loop through some test cases using loops to ensure data validation is robust. Loops are great for automating those repetitive tasks.
Once your logic is ready, let me know. I'll design the UI and ensure the input fields are intuitive. What kind of output should we display to users after a transaction?
We'll need detailed output, transaction IDs, status, and a thank you message. Sarah, don't forget to keep your syntax clean so there's no miscommunication between the front and back end.
Definitely, Emma. I've learned from the last bug. Speaking of which, we should allocate time for debugging. Bugs can derail the entire project.
Agreed. Debugging is a critical step. Sarah, use functions wherever possible to keep the code modular. It'll make debugging easier and improve maintainability.
Will do. For example, I can create a function to calculate totals and another for generating reports.
Great idea, Sarah. For dataset management, we can rely on arrays. They'll help store and manipulate user records effectively.
And for design, I'll ensure the input fields are user-friendly. If the user enters invalid data, the system should provide meaningful output to guide them.
Perfect. Let's sync up again after Sarah sets up the programming environment and defines the variables. Once we have the basics down, we'll tackle debugging and finalize the system. Great teamwork, everyone. Let's get started. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.